Daniel told us to buy this Printrbot, but Daniel left for Canada to go to visit his girlfriend. So now Stephen and me have to figure it out how it works. Well, Stephen did the most work. He put all the software on himself. And now he's gaming again. So now I have to watch this little machine. Nou ja, goed, die eigen ding. Yes. Is dat mijn haar goed? Nou, Steve, vertel even, ga je weer zitten? We zijn 3D aan het plekken. Met onze prot, hoe heet dat ding?
Printrbot. Printrbot Simple Metal.
Simple Metal. Op aan aanwijzing van Daniel. Daniel is net hier. Dit is de laptop. Dat is hooked up to it. Dit is little feature we are printing right now. So you can see already the feet and also the raster for the support. So this takes about 1 hour. 1 hour, right? Yeah. Yeah? Steve? Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
One hour. Okay. Now, well, we'll make it kind of a stop motion, otherwise it will take too long. So, see you later. So now a little bit further. We're still working on this feature here. So, it's working quite quite good. We had a little problem when we started it off. And the impact of this thing was loose here, and also the nozzle had bumped into the bed, but it doesn't seem to bother. I made adjustment for the height. I put the sensor a little bit more up because he was at first he would stay too high over the bed. And the filament did not reach the bed. So at first we made this one, little one, about 2.5 centimeters high, little feature. And then we made this trooper, Star Trek trooper, Star Wars trooper. Like it's meant to be an egg. So that went quite good. Both went quite good. We had a few miss starts at first, but later on it went quite good. Well, this is the hardest one so far because it needed support. And you can see that it makes a little bit of mess. But I think it will be okay. So I will. Plug in later. Shalom. I think this is the hardest one we printed so far. In the back you can see that there's something breaks loose. So I don't know if that's gonna work. Let's see what happens. Okay, we decided to stop this model because it's not gonna work. It doesn't have too less support. So we will increase the fillets. It's now 15%.
Now we'll raise that up to what is it here?
Yeah, it's 15.
15. Mm-hmm. Will we make it 25?
Yeah, 25.
So this is probably also
influencing the support. There will be more support. So I'm gonna stop it now. Okay, I'm gonna try again. Oh, let's heat up a little bit. Now he's gonna aim. Even. He's gonna home. Okay, now he's starting. Oh, that's too deep. Oh, stop him. It's a little bit too deep, it's scratching. You still going?
No.
I have some. Okay. We stopped it because it's a little bit too low. It seems that he is also. Machine, I didn't put the tape on tight enough. I should make it more. So I put on my nail and made it more flush. No. It's quite yeah, he is hitting it now. Oh, he is putting the support on. With a thicker beam. He puts more on now. So this should be better. We'll wait and see. So we put it on raft now, support, so it makes, I think, a little plate in the bottom, like a raft. So he's still working on that, about 2 minutes by now. So this is the creature again we're gonna make, hopefully. Still working on the raft. And now he seems to start working with a different pattern for the support, and he will also start, I think, with the with a little feet. Okay. So he probably he's working on the raft. And now you can see he's building up support, making a little raster. So a little bit further yet. It's the second try. First one ended up like this. There's not enough support. So then we increase the fill amount to from 15 to 25%, and also we made the support we clicked on a raft, so we made a stronger bottom plate, kind of. This is quite flimsy. The other one is stronger. You can see what you can see now is that it starts to make the short in this way, but there's no support, so I don't know why the there's no support there. He didn't do it the first time either. So we'll see what happens. So this is the second day we are printing. Two parts of a cube. It's supposed to fit together. Here you have them on the screen. I made them in Rhino. So we did yesterday the first prints. The first print is not here, I think. But this is the second one. And then we did two other ones who didn't really work out. Another one who did. This worked out, this one. And today we did this part, which goes together with this part. And there should be another part on top yet. We didn't make that. So that works fine so far. This is not all the way flush. So I made a good solution. For the reel, I put the air pressure hose around it, so it would guide it more. And I also put a kind of a brake on there, like little block sitting on there, just to keep tension on the wire. So that is what we did so far. So as soon as those blocks are ready, we will make another part of the loop. So the parts are done. Break them loose. Now it's supposed to fit in each other like this. Actually, it's supposed to screw in each other, but oh.
Hey, Nikita.
I guess they just join together like this. So it's quite good, I think. I put about 2/10 of a millimeter play between them, or 30 by 30 millimeter cube. Together. So I made it in Rhino. See where I have it. See here we have the two parts. I also have